Hello friends, how are you? This is Vibhor here and I'm back with another video in the YouTube series. Now many people ask me questions about what camera I use for my YouTube recording. So in this video, I'm gonna break down what camera I use, why I use that camera and all the settings that I use in the camera to shoot the clear videos that I get out over here. But before that, those of you who do not know me, my name is Vibhor. I make YouTube content regarding technology, especially about Apple products. Also, I make videos about how to get successful on YouTube. So if any of this interests you and you are new over here, please consider subscribing. So coming to what I use Canon M50 for recording everything on my YouTube. That's my primary camera. That is what I am recording on right now. Now I use Canon M50 because this is a very good mirrorless entry-level camera. I love the dual pixel focus that is given by Canon in this camera, which is amazing. I can move my head anywhere in the shot and it will automatically track my head every time, and it's gonna be like blazing fast autofocus. I'm 100% sure I will always be in focus. Also, the sensitivity of the sensor on this camera with the outdoor lights is amazing. The picture comes out to be much brighter and it's overall much visible. Now before this, I actually had this DSLR which I used to shoot the videos and take all the pictures. Now the problem with this is, as you can see, this is super heavy and I'm not very comfortable carrying this around with me. So I moved on to the mirrorless Canon M50. Now this camera is super light, super sleek. I can carry it anywhere with me in my backpack. Outside, it's like super easy and super handy to carry around with you anywhere. So this is the entry level mirrorless camera from Canon, not very expensive. I purchased this for $800 with the lens over here in Australia. I mean, for starting a YouTube channel, this is the best that you can get right now. And that's why this is so popular among the YouTubers around the world. Now also, it does have this swivel screen, which would show me exactly where I am right now. So I can place myself in the shot super easy using this camera, just bringing the screen right in front of me. So that is a super handy feature which I love about these Canon cameras. For a YouTuber like me who works individually, like I'm a single YouTuber, I don't have a team or anybody, I shoot my own videos, I edit my own videos in my free time. So this is the best thing. I can see exactly where I am, I can see the frame and everything, and then start that recording. Now coming to what settings I use over the camera. So it's a very simple thumb rule over here. Being in PAL regions, which is Australia, UK and India, over these regions, your frame rate is supposed to be 24 FPS. So you got to put your frame rate to 24 or 25 FPS. If you are in US, your frame rate is supposed to be 30 FPS. I will not go deep inside how the videography works, but frame rate is actually when you see a video, there are like multiple shots of pictures which are run back to back. So what frame rate is, 25 FPS means in 1 second, 25 photos have been taken by the camera and they have been run at a speed of 25 frames, 25 pictures per second to show you that video running. So if you are in PAL regions, it's 25 FPS, 24 FPS. The closest to that. Now the Canon has got 23.98 frames per second as the standard, so I use 23.98 FPS. Now when it comes to the shutter speed, the thumb rule is shutter speed is supposed to be double or in the direct multiple of what your frame rate is. So now because your frame rate is 24 FPS, your shutter speed is going to be 1/48. Now 1/48 is not a standard shutter speed, so what I'm shooting it at is 1/50. Now if you are in US, your frame rate would be 30 FPS, so that is why your shutter speed is going to be 1/60th over there. Now next important thing for exposure is the aperture number. Now aperture is supposed to be like the opening that the lens has. The more the opening is, the lesser aperture number, that would get more light into the sensor. So my thumb rule over here is go as low as you can on the aperture. For indoor shoots, this lens is at f2. So my aperture is wide open at f2.0 right now. And the last part is the ISO. The higher the number at ISO, the lens is going to get more light in there. But again, if the number is higher, you will get that grain and distortedness in the picture. So the thumb rule over there is have the ISO as low as possible. Right now, what I'm shooting at is frame rate is 23.98 frame per second. Shutter speed is 1/50th. Aperture is f2. And ISO is somewhere around, as of now, 140. So ISO I put at auto, but generally I have set up that the ISO should not go more than 500. So that's all the settings that I do. And once that is done, I just sit in front of the camera, press that record button, and then start blabbering right in front of the camera. If you have any further question about how I do all that stuff, or if you have any counter questions, just do let me know. I would be happy to help. I'm here just for you, just to help you out. Just let me know. And also, if you got something from this video, do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will see you again in the next video, guys. Bye.